As Judge Masipa prepares to deliver her verdict, we know she's had to go through thousands of pages of court documents. But at the heart of her decision is if she believes Oscar Pistorius' version of events. So what does he say happened that night? Let's take a look. Pistorius says that he and Steenkamp went to bed around 10 p.m. He was sleeping here on the left side of the bed and Riva was on the right. He then says he got up in the middle of the night without his prosthetic legs to move some fans from a balcony doorway. It was then he said that he heard a noise in the bathroom, crossed back to the left-hand side of the bed and got his gun from under it. He says he whispered to Riva Steenkamp, who he thought was still in bed, to call the police and moved in down the hallway, gun pointed forward. It was then he heard another noise from inside the bathroom. Overcome with fear and believing an intruder was about to open the toilet door, he fired four quick shots through the door. The prosecution, though, has a different theory. They say Oscar and Riva weren't sleeping, that they were having a fight that night, one that a neighbor says she heard. They point to the contents of Riva's stomach, which, according to a prosecution pathologist, suggests she ate 2 hours before her death. That's different from Pistorius's account that they went to bed 5 hours before the shooting. The prosecution says at some point Riva locked herself in the bathroom to get away from Pistorius, and in a rage he fired four shots through the door with the intent of killing her. Witnesses say they heard terrified screams from a woman during this time, implying Pistorius knew she was behind the door. But the defense says it was actually Pistorius screaming for help, and some of the shots could have been Pistorius breaking down the door with his cricket bat. Two versions of events. Now Judge Masipa must decide which one is the most credible. Robyn Curnow, CNN.